ஹாய், வெல்கம் டு பரிவு டிவி. பரிவு டிவி வழங்கும் சந்தித்ததும் சாதித்ததும். இப்ப நம்ம பார்க்க போற என்டர்பிரனர் மிஸ்டர் நரசிம் ஜமீன், ப்ரொப்ரைட்டர் ஆஃப் ஜமீன் பார்மசூட்டிகல்ஸ். இன்னைக்கு நமக்காக அவருடைய எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ ஷேர் பண்ண வந்திருக்காரு. வாங்க அவர்கிட்டயே பேசலாம். ஹலோ சார், வெல்கம் டு அவர் சேனல்.
ஹலோ, மை நேம் இஸ் டாக்டர் நரசிம் ஃப்ரம் ஜமீன். ஐ கம் ஃப்ரம் ஜமீன் பார்மசூட்டிகல்ஸ் அண்ட் ஜமீன்ஸ் வெல்னஸ் கிளினிக், which is a 120-year-old Ayurvedic clinic and pharmaceutical company in Mylapore. We are based out of Chennai. We've been here for more than a century. And we are a purely Ayurvedic company. Very many companies, very many children, very many adults who have been sick, who have lost hope, and whose doctors have given up on them and have told them that, you know, you need to set your affairs right. So we have taken those cases and we have actually helped them live a full, fruitful life.
So can you say, when have you started your career?
Now, this company was started by my great-grandfather in the late 1800s, and it's been passed on for the last four generations. My great-grandfather is Dr. Jami Venkatramanaya Garu, and he is instrumental in eliminating a disease called Indian childhood cirrhosis from the medical textbooks. So that in itself shows how amazing the medicines that we've been using are. And all the formulations that we have right now have been passed on to us over the last four generations, so the last 100 years, and our processes right now are exactly the same. We haven't deviated from the way he has told us to make the medicines, except in that right now it's been a lot more mechanized, probably because we are scaling up, we have a lot more units to sell, so the amount of scaling has increased, so it's a little mechanized. But in terms of the processes that we follow, in terms of marinating something in a certain liquid for, if it says 24 hours for 7 days, we continue doing that. We don't try to cut corners, which is why our medicines are really so efficacious. We were mostly a clinic based company where we had clinics all across the country in the pre-independence era, and then after that we had clinics that were dwindling down because all the doctors in those clinics passed on, and we decided to finally come back in the last 5 years to a traditional medical representative based model. So we've started marketing our medicines in a very aggressive manner in Tamil Nadu first, and then in Karnataka, in the southern states, Kerala and Andhra, and then we moved to Gujarat because Gujarat is a very huge Ayurvedic market. Now, we've seen that the response to our medicines is fantastic because we're able to cure all diseases from head to toe, migraines, coughs, colds, asthma, bronchitis, any upper respiratory disorders, then heartburn, digestion, digestive disorders, gastric problems, internal bleeding, liver problems especially, because people are just... Fatty liver is really the scourge of people right now because they have very unhealthy lifestyles, a lot of stress, and we try to address these issues using all the medicines that we have. Then arthritis, diabetes, skin problems, skin and joint ailments. So you name it, we have it. As a matter of fact, our medicines are so effective for people who have undergone chemotherapy, because chemotherapy is such a rigorous and such a toxic regimen to the body. It not only kills cancerous cells, but it also kills healthy cells. So you need to protect the healthy cells. So what we've done is we've put them on a regimen of Jami's Liver Cure and Jami's Nutritone, which helps them recoup their strength. And so this is something that we're trying to popularize, saying that, don't worry about chemo. If you have to do chemo, please go ahead and do it. Because, allopathy is not all bad. You have to do a few things because allopathy helps you in those things, but when you have to protect your body, you really need Ayurveda, and that's the message we're trying to get across. And the challenge we're facing right now is that people seem to think that Ayurveda is only kashayams and massages, which is not the case at all. And another common myth that people have is that Ayurveda is very slow acting and it takes a long time, which is again not the case, because Ayurveda takes just as long as allopathy does. And another common myth that people have is, no, Ayurveda means you have to be on a diet. Well, yeah, you have to be on a diet even if you are an allopathy. If you go to a diabetologist, what does he ask you to do? He tells you not to take sugar. He tells you not to eat rice in large quantities. He tells you to stay away from, gluten. He tells you to stay away from refined flour. That's diet, right? Telling you not to eat something and eat something else is diet. Same thing we do in Ayurveda, but it's just got a bad name because of various forces over the last 100 years. So diet is a very important aspect of medicine, whether you're doing allopathy or Ayurveda. And when we tell people not to eat a few things, it's so that the recovery is much faster. You've already ruined your body, so you have to make sure that you help get it back on track as soon as possible. Something you have to do to help your body heal faster. And if you're obese, we tell you not to eat fatty foods. So that's diet again. So these are all things that are very common, whether you're in allopathy or in Ayurveda. So patyam or diet is mandatory for good health. So please understand that just because a doctor or an Ayurvedic doctor tells you that you have to maintain a diet, it's not something that you should shun, because the allopaths say the same thing, they just say it in a much more palatable manner. And that's exactly what we are trying to do. What we are trying to do at Jummies is to get people to understand that yes, diet is important. We will give you medicines to help you overcome your problems, your health problems, but it's also equally important that you do your bit. We'll get you close to the finish line, but you need to actually finish the entire race yourself.
Super, sir. Can you share a few words about awareness of Ayurveda medicine?
People seem to think that Ayurveda is something that has a lot of bad metals. Now, we're trying really hard to educate people, saying that metals are not bad. It's heavy metals, for example, lead, arsenic. Those are the kinds of things that you need to be careful about. Metals are a very important part of your diet. For example, zinc. That's a metal. Iron is a metal. Copper is a metal. All of these metals are absolutely mandatory for you to function properly. Without zinc, your brain doesn't function. Without zinc, your reproduction system doesn't function. Without iron, you don't have proper blood. Without copper, many of your enzymes don't function. So, metals have been given a bad name again by various marketing forces. Metals are very important. It's just that we use metals in the form of very fine nanoparticles called basmas. Basmas are nothing but advanced methods of preparing metals into very, very, very small particles called nanoparticles. That's the catchword right now. We used to call them basma about a century ago, but now it's called nanoparticles, and they all have the same effect. They help in carrying the medicines into your body at a much easier manner. They help in assimilation of these medicines. They're called carriers. These metals are very important for you to not only act as a catalyst for helping your enzymes work better, but also helping carrying the other drugs into your cells so that they start doing the job much better. So these are things that we are trying to face and understand how to address, because there seems to be a lot of bad press about Ayurveda. And one of the things that we do on our Facebook page, if you go to facebook.com/Jummies Pharmaceuticals and Jummies Wellness Clinic, you will see that we try to educate people, saying that it's not voodoo, it's not just Sanskrit that we're talking about. We're actually showing that Ayurveda is a very scientific method. We've actually worked with the University of Delhi, University of Madras, Indian Institute of Delhi, Tata Memorial Hospital in Bombay. All of these institutes have we've collaborated with them. We've shown that the pathways that our medicines, the Jummies medicines, take towards eliminating certain diseases and addressing certain diseases are very molecular at the molecular level. And we've shown that, for example, in collaboration with IIT Delhi, we've shown that one of the ways in which Jummies Liver Cure combats hepatitis B is by working on the DNA of the hepatitis B virus. And that's something that's very unique to an Ayurvedic company, is to go down to the molecular level. So these are all things that we do, and we're a very scientific company. We use very traditional medicines, but we use modern methodology, we use scientific methods, we use the present day techniques prevalent right now to understand how these medicines work. And we've shown that Ayurveda is a very safe science, it's a very effective science, and the medicines that we use and very all bona fide Ayurvedic medicines are very fast acting. You don't have to worry about taking a long time, which it doesn't really. You could come to us and we'll probably help you cure your cold in 3 days as opposed to 7 days with any other allopathic medicine. So it's not slow acting. It depends on the disease. So for example, if you have cirrhosis of the liver, yes, it will take time to cure it, because you've ruined your liver over several decades of abuse of using alcohol or eating fatty food or whatever. So you can't expect miracles and say, you know what, I have cirrhosis, I want to be cured in a month. It's not going to happen. At the same time, we will definitely help you, prevent going to a hospital to get a transplant, which is going to be very expensive. By taking our medicines, you don't have to do all that. It will take time, but that's the price you pay. Okay. So this is what we're trying to do. We're trying to educate people at the same time, popularizing the concept of Ayurveda and making people understand that Ayurveda is a very solid science. And as a matter of fact, the techniques that are being used right now are still not yet advanced to understand how Ayurveda works. So our Facebook page is facebook.com/Jammies Wellness Clinic. And we have another Facebook page called facebook.com/Jammie Pharmaceuticals. Our clinic is here in Mylapore in Jammie Buildings. It's very easy to find. It spans both PM Street and Roy Petta High Road. So walk-ins are welcome. We have doctors from the morning till the evening. But we recommend that you take an appointment just so that you don't have to wait for too long. Our numbers are 2499-1439. You can call our landline. We also have a cell phone number where you can contact the person and set up an appointment. The number is 904-302-0764. One of these two numbers you can contact anytime. info@jammie.org also gives you a lot of access to us 24/7 by email. We have products ranging from head to toe. These include Jammie's Redima, Jammie's Liver Cure, Jammie's Huko, Jammie's Swascolin, Jammie's Degermin, just the skin cream that I was telling you about, Jammie's D-Tabs for diarrhea, Jammie's Nilomit for vomiting, Jammie's Orthoraksha for joint pains, Jammie's Madhumehari for diabetes, you name it, we have various different medicines. So please step into our clinic. And I tell you is two things, two very important things for all the youngsters: stay away from fast food. You won't believe it, but I've just given up sugar. Not sweets. I love sweets. I'm saying stay away from white sugar. Use other kinds of sugar. Use other kinds of sweets. Because white sugar is really, really bad for you because it's refined. One more thing you have to remember, all the youngsters, if any advertisement tells you that this uses refined something, refined flour or refined oil or refined sugar, don't use it. Anything refined is bad for you. Anything unrefined is good for you. So unrefined sugar, unrefined flour, unrefined oil, these are all things that are really good for you. Unrefined is the way to go. If you can afford it, go organic. If you can't, just stay away from the things that I've told you about it. What I tell youngsters is stay away from fast food as much as you can. I'm not saying don't go, because it's very difficult to not eat fries and pizzas and burgers or whatever it is, but try to limit yourself. Don't eat it every day. Eat food made at home, right? So it's very important. So let food be your medicine. Okay, that's what you should really focus on. When food is your medicine, you really don't need outside medicine. You just remember that. And thank you so much to Parivu TV for allowing me to be a part of Sandhitadum Sadhitadum. I would really like to appreciate the work that's being done at Parivu TV and also to their founder and co-ordinator. Thank you.
Wow, really, Ayurveda medicine treatment was very healthy medicine to take, sir. Thank you so much, sir, for being with us today and shared your profound knowledge with us. Thank you. Keep supporting our channel, Sandhitadum Sadhitadum. உங்களுக்கு இந்த வீடியோ பிடிச்சிருந்தா லைக் பண்ணுங்க, ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க அண்ட் மறக்காம சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுங்க. நீங்க ஒரு சக்சஸ்ஃபுல் என்டர்பிரனரா மறக்காம பரிவு டிவியை காண்டாக்ட் பண்ணுங்க. தேங்க்யூ.